فمن أظلم ممن كذب على الله وكذب بالصدق إذ جاءه أليس في جهنم مثوى للكافرين.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم انفعنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة يا أرحم الراحمين. وبعد، just 24 continues the Surah Zumar, and at the beginning of just 24, the verse that Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما described as أرجى آية في كتاب الله is found. The verse that he described as the verse that gives the most hope to in the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Say, O my slaves who wronged themselves, do not despair of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so, as this surah speaks for sincerity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us so much hope within this one verse. And as you read this verse, you should really feel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to you directly, يَا عِبَادِي, O my slaves. Every single one does israf. Every single one violates themselves. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leaves the door of repentance and the door of forgiveness over, but calling us, anibu ila rabbikum, return back to your Lord, to repent to your Lord. Wattabi'u ahsana ma unzila ilaykum, and follow the best of what's been, it's all good. Follow the truth that's revealed to you. So a real verse calling us with sincerity to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it's too late. We have three verses that put real fear into our hearts. After the verse of hope, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us, turn back before it's too late. أَن تَقُولَ نَفْسٌ يَا حَسْرَةَ. In case there comes a day when a soul will say, يَا حَسْرَةَ عَلَى مَا فَرَّطُ فِي جَنْبِ اللَّهِ. Oh woe to me, oh anguish, oh remorse for all of these opportunities I missed with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين، أو تقول لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. People on the day of judgment will be saying, if only I had one more chance, I'll be from those who do good. If only I had one more chance, if only I was returned back, I'll be from those who are guided. بلى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says never. Never. So we're given warnings, and then the surah ends with some graphic descriptions of the day of judgment and of the end of this world. Allah speaks about the blowing of the trumpet, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ, that the trumpet will be blown and everything will come out and go out of existence. But then the trumpet will be blown again and everything will come back into existence. And then you have fawj, then you have the two groups of humanity. Allah describes about how the unbelievers will be led into hellfire and immediately flung into hellfire. And as they flung into hellfire, they'll be told, didn't the messengers come to you? Didn't the warning come to you? Didn't the message come to you? And then people of paradise, as they're led into paradise, they'll be told the words, as they'll be told, as they're entering into paradise, Salamun alaykum, peace be upon you. So that's Surah Zumar, one of the great surahs in the Quran, which if you reflect over the meanings of them, it instills sincerity in the heart. Then after Surah Zumar, we go on to the first of the Hamim surahs. We have seven surahs in the Quran it's rare in the Quran. They were revealed in order, and they're in that order in the Quran. It's rare to find that within the Quran. So the seven Hamim surahs revealed one after the other, and they're placed in the Quran one after the other. And there are great themes. When you look at all of these seven Hamim surahs together, which spans almost two juz of the Quran, when you look in, there are great themes about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and about the Quran and about the messengers that revelation was sent to. So when we look at the first of them, Surah Ghafir, also known as Surah Mu'min, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins by speaking about the rejection of people, how they deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then immediately moves on to give some descriptions about the terrors of the Day of Judgment. So you have in there the verse, لِمَنِ الْمُلْكُ الْيَوْمِ لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَارِ, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, who has the kingdom on this day? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the answer, لِلَّهِ, The kingdom is only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one, the irresistible, the all powerful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks, it gives a description about the day of judgment, about how hearts will come up to the throats in a state of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then most of the surah then goes on to a discussion about Musa and Fir'aun. Musa alayhi salam and Fir'aun. But here with a different slant. Now here we have a discussion about the arrogance of Fir'aun, where he claims that he has a kingdom the likes of which no other kingdom on the face of the earth. Like Musa alayhi salam warning him not to be arrogant, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed nations that went before. But we have an individual who's introduced in this passage who's not spoken of anywhere else in the stories of Musa and Fir'aun, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about رَجُلٌ مِّنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ يَكْتُمُ إِيمَانَهُ, a man from the family of Fir'aun. A man from the family of Fir'aun. And it is said it was the cousin of Fir'aun. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said he was a secret believer, يَكْتُمْ إِيمَانَهُ, out of fear he didn't come out openly and declare his faith. But at the same time, even though initially he didn't declare his faith, he spoke to Fir'aun, trying to convince him about accepting the message of Musa alayhi salam. أَتَقْتَلُونَ رَجُلًا أَنْ يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ, are you going to kill a man who says my Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's brought you the proofs to show that. So he speaks in defense of Musa alayhi salam, even though he's not declared publicly that he's a believer. And then he speaks to his people and says, ya qawmi, like some real, when you see those verses, ya qawmi, oh my people, he's calling them upon them to accept the message of Musa alayhi salam, to accept the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Eventually, having declared his faith, he's then killed. He's then killed, but amongst the last words that he says before he's killed, فَسَتَذْكُرُونَ مَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ وَأُفَوَّضُ أَمْرِي إِلَى اللَّهِ, that you'll soon remember what I'm saying to you, but I resign my affair, I leave my affair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about the punishment that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next world will bring to Fir'aun and the people who follow Fir'aun. And the surah ends by speaking about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives victory to the prophets. Inna lanansuru rusulana. We'll give victory to our prophets. We give victory to our prophets and all those who follow our prophets. Then you have after Surah Ghafir, the second of the Hamim surahs, known Surah Fussilat. Surah Fussilat or Surah Hamim Sajda. Surah Fussilat or Surah Hamim Sajda begins where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenges the unbelievers in Mecca about their rejection and warns them about their failure to accept the message, warning them that they will be destroyed like the people of Ad and the people of Thamud and were destroyed before them. And then describing scenes of the Day of Judgment where the unbelievers will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you have those frightening verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the very limbs on the body speaking and testifying. The hands will speak about the wrong that was done, the feet and the eyes and every limb, to the point where a person will turn against himself and say, لِمَ شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا, will say to his limbs, Why did you testify? Why did you testify? Why did you bear witness against me? And the answer from the limbs, which are almost like independent human beings, أَنْطَقَنَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي أَنْطَقَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ, like the one who made everything speak, made us speak. After that, you have some verses of hope. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. After giving some graphic descriptions of punishment in the unbelievers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives descriptions of the best of believers, how they leave this world. Those who say Allah is my Lord and they remain steadfast on that claim. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala devoutly throughout their life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that at that moment, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, angels descend upon them, telling them you have nothing to fear. We will be with you. We'll be with you in this world and we'll be with you. We'll be with you in the next world. And then the verses speak about the great signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارِ, the night and the day and the sun, the moons and so on, how all of these submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and calls us to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The juz ends by calling the unbelievers to accept the truth of the Quran, to accept the truth of the message, and to stop their denial, to stop their denial of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Quran and the message of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها وما ربك بظلام للعبيد.